Hi, my name is David Friedman, and I'm the Organic SEO Manager at PaperStreet. Today, I'm going to quickly go over five awesome and useful features found within Google Webmaster Tools. If you'd like to learn more in-depth information, please read my blog post below for more details. First of all, if you're not familiar with Google Webmaster Tools, it's a must-have tool for valuable insight into how your website's performing. The five sections that I'm going to be covering today are search analytics, manual action penalties, site links, links to your site, and fetches Google. Okay, so the first section I'm going to cover is called Search Analytics, and in order to navigate to this section, you're going to go ahead and click on Search Traffic and then on Search Analytics. All right, so I'm just going to briefly cover this section. This area is going to tell you exactly what search queries are bringing traffic to your site. You could literally see what keywords are driving traffic to your site. You can also see other valuable information related to the number of impressions, your click-through rate, and your approximate keyword ranking position. So this section of Google Webmaster Tools is going to give you great insight to find out how people are finding your website, what keywords are attracting people to visit your website. And you could also find untapped resources if you were to come across a keyword that you see is bringing in a lot of traffic, something you weren't necessarily targeting. You can go ahead and capitalize on this by creating more content because you know this is what your readers are looking for and what they're interested in. The next section I'm going to cover is called Manual Action Penalties, and in order to navigate to this, you're going to actually stay under the search traffic area, but go ahead and click on Manual Actions. So, Manual Action Penalties, most of the time, a Google algorithm is going to cause a penalty to occur on your website, but there are certain times where an actual member of the Google spam team is going to manually review your website to see if there are any infractions. This portion of Google Webmaster Tools, you can think of it as almost like a direct line of communication with the spam team. You're going to be informed if your website was penalized by a manual review. So I have also included, if you're interested to know what are the types of penalties that can be applied to your website through a manual action, I've included a link from Google below that's going to explain in depth what to be aware of and what to look out for. Okay, moving on the next section I'm going to cover is called Site Links. And in order to navigate to this, you're going to click on Search Appearance and then Site Links. So if you're not familiar with the term site links, they're automatically generated links that are going to appear in the search engine result page for your website. So Google often tries to find the most important subpages of your website and present those in the search results. So this is going to allow a user to directly go to an important page without having to kind of navigate and look around on your website. So what's great about Google Webmaster Tools is that you can actually request a removal of any site links that you that Google has chosen that you don't want to appear. So unfortunately, you can't tell Google exactly what you want to appear, but they at least allow you control on removing certain items that Google will automatically add to your site links. So if you don't feel it's an important page, let's say by accident Google is showing maybe like a legal disclaimer or a sitemap page that you feel is not very important, you can go ahead and denote a site link by using this great tool within Webmaster Tools. Okay, moving on, the next section I'm going to cover is called Links to Your Site. And in order to navigate to this, you're going to go ahead and click on Search Traffic and then click on Links to Your Site. So this section of the dashboard is going to provide you with really great insight into what other websites are linking back to you. So in Google's eyes, when they see other websites linking to you, it can either count as a positive or a negative vote. It's going to depend on the quality and the industry of the website. If a website that's linking back to you is looking very spammy, it's outdated, it doesn't relate to your industry, this is going to count actually against your website. But on the contrary, if it's a high quality, highly accredited website that's related to your the industry that you work in, your company, it's going to count as a positive vote. This is what Google wants to see. They want to see that there are other highly accredited websites that are linking to you that find your information useful. So it's just going to look better on your behalf. So basically, this section is going to allow you to see also your most linked content. So you know that people are linking back to you, but if you want to find out exactly what pages they are linking to, you can go ahead and find that out through this section. And also, you're able to see how your data is linked, meaning like what kind of words are other people using to link back to your website. This is commonly referred to as anchor text. So by clicking on that section, you're able to basically see, hey, were they using our company name? Were they, how are they referring to us when they linked back to our website? The next, and actually the last section is going to be called Fetch as Google, and this can be found under the Crawl section. So this is actually a great tool to make sure that Google is rendering and understanding your website correctly. You're able to see if any resources or important files are being blocked that can prevent Google from fully understanding your website. So in the past, Google search engines weren't as sophisticated. They weren't really able to understand complex languages such as CSS or JavaScript, and basically they were only able to read the text on your website. But now it's very important that you provide Google with full access to these files so that they can fully render and understand the design, the layout, and everything there is to do with your website. So that basically wraps up what I'm going to be covering today. As you can see, there are a lot more areas within Google Webmaster Tools, but I wanted to present you with five sections to, help you get started and help you get acclimated to the tool. But please feel free to explore the rest of Google Webmaster Tools and see what else it has to offer. So, thank you very much for taking the time to listen to me today. I hope I was able to teach you a few things about Google Webmaster Tools and help you get more oriented with the program. Thank you very much.